Hello, I'm Gabriele Trombini, someone I know yet, and I'm a member of the SIG Fedora-Join. Today we talk about the rescue of Mary, who is marooned in the Fedora Sea. Why marooned? Because if you have to surf the wiki, you probably get lost. In the general part, we talk about the target, goal, structure, workflow, and getting help. Then there is another part. The target is the process, unify the common parts of the group's join steps. Well, every group has a join page with some steps which probably can be unified in one. As I say, help people to be less scared of the wiki. I think it doesn't need any explanation. Stop people escaping because of wiki issues. It's the same. Leading recruiting to higher rates. What is this? This is the join group try to get the recruiting is a bad word, but I don't see anything else to say the same meaning. Probably the join group can unifying the common parts of the join process have more contributors than before, because the we see later, they are following, they are instructed, they are more, less confused than they go to the wiki themselves. Okay? Circo?
Yeah. No, it's okay. I'm totally agree with that. I mean, I don't know if you know my slides on my FPO account.
No,
I use always to make the join Fedora workshops. And I have all non-technical contributors as one page.
Yeah.
So you it's designed, of course, so you have a little boy or girl who makes this job, and then you have the description what you have to do for getting part of this group. And then I have, it starts with the name of the URL in the wiki that they are all different. And then are some steps all different. I agree totally that that this has been unified, but the point I have that the join group exists since 5 years.
Yeah.
And we have talked definitely since 5 years to do this, and nothing happened. So the join group is a bunch, for me personally, a bunch of people who are sitting in the IRC, have their own IRC channel and do nothing.
At the moment, the join group has been renewed because Pete, me and Ankur take care of the join part.
We had the great join pages, and you know, we can improve them with the join pages.
You're right, though. It's a lot easier to talk about it than it is to actually go out and do things.
Yeah. Now, it's not heavy to do things. Just do it.
Point.
It's not heavy to do things. You can always talk. We have to improve. We have to improve. You can talk this, yes, but nobody of us will stand up and do it. You have to do it by yourself. If you have this feeling, do it. Point. You might get in some fights about this when it comes to unifying, because you have to speak to the other groups that we have to unify it. So you have to start doing it. That's the whole point. And join group, the idea is nice, but
that you know, is difficult to have. From the SIG wiki page, the goal, set up a communication channel between the existing contributors and prospective contributors to us. This is clear. We take care of the contributor questions and speak with the groups, leaders or members, okay? From better mentor-mentee relationships. There are some groups that need mentorship, okay? So we can create an easy way to go to the mentorship of the contributor. Give a communication channel to converse among themselves. In the join channel, for example, you can speak, you can talk, you can ask everything. Make it easier for the new folk to learn by getting them started on simple tasks. Well, we have a track where we can create some tasks, for example, on Ambassador, on I don't know how, but we can do that with our tech. Are you okay? Is okay for you?
What?
Using our tech for helping people.
Using
to
track?
Yeah, helping people to
easily. You cannot take away from the teams. That's not possible. They will never agree to that. That you define how they make their things. That you have to definitely to leave up to them. And if you talk to the teams, it makes the processes they have with teams, they make totally sense this from their perspective.
This point is more about, we have the Easy Fix app, all of these groups have track.
Nobody knows really about Easy Fix.
So no,
that's
a lot of it is
we
just
have to
talking
make
about
Easy
it
Fix approach more prominent. That's one of the points. You know.
Yeah.
The point to getting more contributors is, I don't know if you remember Max Weber? Yes, he was, I think, 2008 in my hometown. And he gave a talk there. The talk was innovations of the Fedora project, and it was not about innovations, it was in the end how to fetch contributors. The problem is only they have to get this step from a consumer to a contributor. You have to just make something. And the something can be a so-called low-hanging fruit, like the supplemental wallpaper. It's a low-hanging fruit, it's your first contribution, and then you realize, if they have realized, oh, that can be easy, I'm now doing something for Fedora, and I want to do more, you know? And then you guide them in, that's the way how it's done. It's not just unifying, nobody comes out of, yeah, I want to start contributing to Fedora. It's normally they are users, and they have to be transformed from the user to a contributor. It's not that somebody out of a black mass comes and said, I want to contribute to Fedora. That's, we have to make our low-hanging fruits, like the easy fixes, more prominent, so that our users find them easier. And we have also to create some low-hanging fruits to make the first step out of consumer to a contributor easier. I agree that we can unify the steps. You can look to my talk, and if you look, there are only on two or three teams something different, and there it makes really sense. And What can be unified is finding the steps in the wiki to unify the URL.
The discussion we've had about unifying isn't saying everybody's going to go through the exact same process through the same mechanism, and then at the end it just spits you out into the converts. It's not that kind of unification. It's more saying that as a SID, we should be looking at what the onboarding experience is for each of these other groups, identifying common things, identifying what each group is doing well, and seeing how those successes can be applied to other groups. So it's not wholesale taking that process and saying, you all have to do this thing now, no, but it's...
That, that will definitely also never work, because you cannot demand the teams what they have to do.
No, no, and hopefully the teams are participating as well.
Yeah.
And like one of the things that we identified for this was the introduction email. Every group says, we have a mailing list, please introduce yourself. We're all friends, we're all people.
Let's
say hello. And some of them have templates that end up getting filled out, and I am Charles, and I work at the bank, and I like Fedora because it is fun, and I like free software, and they spit something out that's very, it's not very engaging for the reader or for the writer, but some groups have something that's a lot more engaging, and
yeah.
So we can take that and make that idea of an engaging introduction and share it. And have the engaging questions be something different for each group.
I think the best idea is Sarup can see, I don't know if you have ever seen the Mozilla engagement pages. How they do it. I don't know the URL.
I don't even know how you would define activity in this process. There's no activities that we declare that this is Fedora Join. This is what we did as part of Fedora Join.
That's the problem. I said I have with the Fedora Join thing. The idea Ankur had there is a very nice one, but he totally fucked up to give it life. No.
Yeah.
That's the problem. I mean. They changed it a little bit, but that's a nice overview page how you can contribute to Fedora, to Mozilla right now. You know, you have the different kind of things. You can look what I have to do there, and then you find out, well, that's something what I could do,
right?
What I think I can do, and then you look up for the process. How do I get to that?
Right.
And so,
I was just going to say that for a lot of the people that are interested in join sync, it's probably a peripheral activity for them,
mm-hmm.
and it's probably a really good opportunity for you to lead efforts that I could throw like 2 hours a week into.
Yeah.
Or, you know, just set up a framework for people that do want to join the community and lead community-based rather than technical direction, and you can just point them and say, well, I've got a rotation of people ready to mentor, you know, whatever you want to set up.
I've got like a huge laundry list of stuff, wish list that I have from Council, Red Hat, OSAS, from FPL, former FPLs. It's just
go to my FPL.
From there, there's this comms idea that is being tossed around, which
right.
came up about the same time that Bosco did. Bosco was decided as a directional. I had my way, I would still spend another 2 or 3 months just listening and figuring out what everybody is, because like
yeah.
it's an oxymoron to be like, you can't just be like drop in to be a community leader. You need to establish and like the community needs to be legitimately interested in you leading. You can't just be like, okay, I'm here and I'm gonna lead now. Like that's very much a problem. Like I've been like walking on eggshells, like trying to figure out, but like, I think I've got a decent handle on the problem space. I've got a decent set of tools in the toolbox, and like Fedora-Join as a SIG is like, it's been around for a while. I know there are people who are paying attention. And like, the at this point, like I'm excited. I think I've got some of these problems, at least some ideas for proposing and figuring it out.
Yeah.
Just need to find and develop a new kind, a new base of contributors, right? Because like you said, it's a peripheral activity for a lot of people, because everybody's primarily working on other stuff. But like, we need people who are primarily interested in doing community architecture building, community
yeah.
infrastructure building.
And I'm excited about how
yeah.
much for that, just the community introspection piece of it. I think that there are a lot of things that could be considered when you say activity going on, but people don't do it in that context.
Oh, you have a button that Hyatt conference, it's the right one.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's just...
Okay.
No, it's Fedora people, not projects.
Sorry. Yeah.
I think
kind of
maybe
Fedora
people
should
be
doing
it, but they should be not being focused as it's planned in the hubs.
Mm-hmm.
With the hubs, I think we're going to change this, and actually, as the people are saying, hey, this activity is for me, and see a button or an app or something like that. Just taking the and receiving some kind of mentoring or leadership some from those people who are currently in the join thing. You're gonna guys gonna be the also
cool.
the part
right.
of the mentoring team.
Mm-hmm.
And with this way, I think we can revolutionize everything. Because mentoring for a team and mentoring for ambassadors, as we are will revolutionize everything. And will result a proper contributor, a proper ambassador, and a proper coder.
I don't speak Italian.
Why?
We are tying together with the right information into the hubs and building up from bottom top to the leadership, to the council, and so on, that has to benefit, and to from the top to downwards also. I really would like to see also some cooperation, like when I would like to have an hiring desk on the events, that really, really people have noticed that, hey, this is Red Hat, and yeah, Fedora guys, and I'm glad.
Have you
a
passcode for the for the Wi-Fi?
I think this would be
Flux 2050.
Some of the problems that I so far,
Flux
15? One, I
it's just Flux 15.
Like I know there are some mailing lists and I know there are some groups,
mm-hmm.
but like when we want to put out a call for action, like where is the place where we announce community stuff? Is there like an overarching community list?
No.
So that's what I'm hoping the comms can try to do.
Sure.
But at the same time, right, there's like...
In a practical sense, it's like developers.
Right.
Sure.
I mean, the really important part is like everybody's
we made
busy.
It.
And right now, the problem with storytelling and organizing is that you're asking people to choose between building stuff and
it's,
building
talks.
It's overwhelming for a country, a possible country.
Talks and
the
characters like again.
But
yeah.
Well, it's an entire building.
It takes a while.
But like, we find the people who are interested in doing that. A lot of them are going to be on the mentors list from the top. It sounds like JoinSig is also like right along with it. Like the ambassadors list, there's regional ambassadors list, but there's also an ambassadors list overall, I guess. So, you know, I know that FAMSCO going dormant has been a very difficult challenge for ambassadors and everybody in this community stuff.
I don't know.
So like, I tried to post the FAMSCO
nominee
list,
should be shown there or not.
Where are the places
So it's just
at this point,
mouse
I want to start moving. Right?
I don't know.
Yeah, so we have a comma.
You think so?
I'm going to give a lightning talk later tomorrow, where I'm going to say, here's all this community infrastructure that we have.
I cannot.
We have a track. We have.
I'm not able.
Like, if people are interested in doing this stuff, like, I think we just need to like start going.
Robbie,
show it this way, it buzzes. It
looks all into this. Like,
maybe it's better.
So FOSCO, the Fedora Outreach Steering Committee list?
It's just called Outreach.
It's just called Outreach.
So, I mean, in that sense, it's not necessarily tied to that concept.
Sure.
I'm just curious.
Can you take a look? That's my slides. They are available on my FBO account. It's SVG. It's available. You can show the slides directly out of your browser. So. And I have the experience that most people come and say, I can program, I cannot contribute. So I have only the jobs on these slides which have nothing to do with programming or something like that, or packaging. No packaging I have in it. So the point is, these figures you see here, I did 5 years ago. For what? For the join pages. That's the time we talk about that. 5 years ago.
Yeah. Well, we're here. We are here, right?
We have to.
I'm excited because those and they are exactly how people want to talk to.
I mean, you can read it in my blog. There was a lot of people against it because it looks too childish.
Okay.
But like,
you might have some slides further down the line here that answer some of the topics.
So we're good. You got the slides.
So if you look through, I have then always the points what you have to do, what the team does, and then what you have to do. Yeah? And if you look through the points, they are not that much different. It's just on two or three teams. Like we, as design team, we want to have them make a ticket. The infrastructure team wants to have the apprentice group. Makes totally sense because you have not all right to our infrastructure in that role, because you can do a lot of damage if you would have it and you have not the experience. So that's a very good thing to do. But they are already unified. So the point we have, one of the points we should do, first thing is make really good join pages. So we are rebuild our whole web pages right now, so we have to convince Mo and robots to make us nice join pages again.
Yeah.
And that we really invest some time to do this, and it's really, we have to speak with the teams, how can we unify it in the most of the parts to make it easier for the ambassadors to communicate it out. And one thing we have to do, we have to create more low-hanging fruits.
Yeah, I used EasyFix bugs in my class when I taught at RIT. We had a bug fix assignment where new contributors were pointed to. I pointed them at the open hatch mailing lists for bite-sized bugs. I pointed them for EasyFix bugs and a few other places. So I've used it. The problem with a lot of those is it's almost more work for an experienced contributor to make a ticket about an easy fix bug.
I know,
that's
the point.
Yeah.
And like getting people to recognize that is difficult, and they're really easy to close, so they go really quickly.
We had lost flock. Exactly.
It also abstracts the experience from where the work is actually getting done. So you start with an easy fix, and you think, okay, well, I've got all of this set up, and now I'm ready for the things that aren't so easy, and you have to learn a whole different level of tools and apps.
Saruk did last year flock and talk. The name was the experience of a Fedora newbie, and exactly this came up. And Matthew was in this talk, and he made it out that it makes already more work for an experienced developer to mentoring, to really mentor a new contributor as if he would do it itself, but it is worth it. So that's what the Fedora join group would have to communicate to our developers. And one of the points is you have also to find mentors. Because mentoring cannot be done from everyone.
I think it should be unified into two groups. Actually, who are teaching, educating, running the classrooms, and so on. And the ambassadors, actually, who are caring with people and the community and guiding and so on. And yeah, well, the mentoring part actually is really fragmented. And that way, we should unify, get the hubs, jump on the wagon, and we are solving a series of problems that actually
I think we have enough ideas to probably come up with something actionable at the end of the presentation.
Yeah. And you've got slides. I know we've been going back and forth a lot, so if you've got slides, we should probably...
I'm going ahead. At the moment, the structure is contributors, me, Pete, and Hank Ursina. The wiki page, the join SIG wiki page, not the join wiki page. We have a mailing list, we have a ERC channel, the chat system, as we say. I go faster. Allora, contributors can be the one who has a fast account and the ones who have not a fast account. Everyone can contribute. Okay.
No, it's not possible without FES account. You cannot contribute without signing DCA or FPCA. You cannot contribute without it. It's not possible.
In the join SIG, SIG? Yes, you can.
No. What? How you join the join SIG without having a FES account? It's not possible.
No,
there are a lot of...
If reporting boxes is kind of
It's a kind of contributing. Yeah, but you cannot make a Baxilov entry without having FES account.
Well, you can join the IRC channel.
That you can do, yes.
There are a lot of people working for Fedora that haven't a FES account.
But how?
There are stages of participation. We want to get you.
I'm totally aware that it should be. If you talk about the low-hanging fruit, they shall not be depending on a FES account. But right, from the legal point, you cannot have a contribution without signing the license agreement. You know? So the only things you can do is just join a channel and have a conversation with us, or join a mailing list and have a conversation. You know.
It looks like they talk about prospective contributors who aren't signed yet.
Going ahead. This ambiguity. Fedora join page, the main join page, and the SIG join page into the wiki.
Actually, the URL for the Fedora join page is join.fedoraproject.org. It's easier to remember as Fedora project /wiki/join. Yeah.
Mailing list works as each mailing list in the project. And the Fedora join channel for the ones that don't have the IRC, there is a wiki page with instruction for use the chat, the web chat directly from Freenode. If you want to install, WeChat, TextChat, and the specific chat. Okay. It's tech system works exactly as the other groups. You create a ticket, someone take care of it, and then we work on.
Not all the tracks in Fedora work the same way. I can tell you they are totally
talking about structure that we've set up to get work done in the joint city.
Yeah.
Not introducing people to track just within that city, what framework there is.
This is our workflow, expert. Join newbies through the join wiki page. The groups wiki page, I think, are so clear. Then, if you go deeper in the wiki, you can get lost. If not sure what they want to do, take care to understand the skills, expertises, and interests. Well, we see later this point. Driving them step by step along the join process, because it's not, this is my experience. When I joined to the ambassador group, I had some difficulty to understand which step before, which step later, which step, how to ask for a mentor, and so on. I think every join page has this difficult, this issue, somewhere in the process. Of course, if there is a mentorship, the last part of the joint process pick up to the mentors, because we can substitute the mentors with the mentorship. This is a recap of the channels. Oh. Who is Mary? Mary is a fantasy girl that wants to join somewhere in the Fedora project. We have to know why Mary is marooned, understanding Mary, and then rescue her. At last, we have a new contributor. This is Mary steps. Take a look at the wiki. Oh, really? Well, try to follow pages. Well, when you are on the joint page of each group, you can follow simply. When you, Chris, know this. This problem. When you search something about marketing, for example, hundreds of pages of wiki, you get lost for sure.
Yeah, a lot of old stuff from like 99 and stuff.
So get stuck.
Yeah.
Whatever. Then, okay, I go to sleep. This is Mary.
I mean, I really think we should just have like
There's an old tag. I think at the wiki workshop we're going to be tagging old pages as old so that they stop showing up in your search results, I think.
Mm-hmm. At the very least, every once in a while, people that can go through and say, show me all the old pages and then just start the old ones.
Or,
we're
doing
it right now. That's another approach.
Understanding Mary. Mary is a newbie. She's shy because she doesn't know. She has some issue to relationship. This is a fantasy Mary, Circo.
Yeah.
It's not you. It's a fantasy.
You expect a shy girl to open the IRC and question you in Fedora Join channel? That's a problem not only I have with the Join group. That a lot of people inside Fedora
why not?
A problem then.
Why not?
You know?
Is the easiest way to ask for some some help, you know. Self-made, she works as an account or in the marketing of his or her factory, but her hobby is play with the fear. When I started, I had fear to talk with Circo, because Circo is an institution. So it's difficult for someone talking. Hey, Circo, how are you?
I'm fine.
Okay.
I'm German, I answer all this stuff.
The consequence is that the newbie is feeling alone. How can I? How? Can I say? The consequence is turn off the PC and go away for me. This is what happened to me. Okay, how we can rescue Mary? Link to Fedora join ERC or mailing list. Don't think track or history of asset. Make her feel comfortable. We need people who has a relationship capacity. Help her pick an area she'd like to work in. What do you want to do, Mary? I want work with design. Circo, come here, please. No, Circo. Then people can become friends. After, keep in touch, meet at conference, and just have fun making Fedora better. This is a consequence of the joining step. This for excuse. At the moment, we don't have anything that lead the people to Fedora join. Actually, user and also somewhere as well, maybe, perhaps. Hoping in a mail, I write a mail, maybe someone will reply me. This is actually the people want to join to Fedora. Is correct? I insert some points of brainstorming. What's next? Increase visibility of Fedora join seek, make more people aware of it. What do you say there before? Robert, you had to link Fedora join into the FPU. No, you are not here. This is one moment. Mismo before said that probably the hub will be the hub or the Fedora project control.
The hub will unify a lot of sources we have in a better overview, so you have not to go to drag to mailing list to follow up what's going on.
Yeah.
What hub will solve.
Actually,
or at least make it better.
Informing ambassadors.
For
adding groups join process, we talked about it before. Informing ambassadors. Why? Ambassadors, when they have a meeting, a talk, they have to link the people to Fedora-Join. Okay, you want to become a part of the Fedora project? Well, start with Fedora-Join, and then things go ahead. Well, Mary has skills and expertise. She has an ability to interact, I think. And we have to, more important, understand Mary's interest. She's working, as Pete said, she is working in a bank, but she hated her job. Also, if she works on the PC. But she would like to have some interest different, respect the everyday job. So the important part of this let's rescue is the interest of Mary. She likes to draw. Well, design team is for you. No.
Yeah, just for
I go ahead, then we can talk about. Okay, we can suggest the best choice for Mary's that are not able to understand in which group she can work on. So we can explain the list group and choosing with her the group of interest. Okay? I go faster. Okay, when Mary choose the group, we can ask to a SIG member if there is one member in the SIG on the SIG. If there is a member in the SIG to take care of Mary, or we can ask other groups if there are one person to take care of Mary. Then, in the future, we can check Mary integration. Okay, Mary is now a new contributor. After these steps, Mary is a new contributor, fully integrated. Okay, we should keep in touch with Mary because we don't know how the transition will end. We don't have to make Mary doing a step too high. We have to going up easy, in easy way, and then check Mary's gratification. Just a question. Brainstorming, this is the end. Okay. We have to encourage each Fedora team to have a presence in the joint SIG. It's a SIG. It's easier for us. Sirko, you are.
Yeah, it's fine.
You are a member of.
I'm not a member of Join SIG. No.
Tomorrow you are.
Definitely not. I have an opinion not to get a member of this group because of something special. I have a problem. so I will stay out of it. I will definitely contribute without getting a member of this group.
I think we should unify a bunch of things. First of all, yesterday we heard that the campus ambassadors want to do the same thing.
Yeah.
Then mentorship is also want to do the same thing. Then the SIG also wants to do the mentoring, leading, teaching thing.
Yeah.
So what would be that just actually unify these two of one group?
Exactly.
And let it allow to be have a staircase. So campus ambassadors can be the ambassador junior category, just the first level. Then the second one can be the ambassadors, and then the mentors who are just leading, teaching, and more.
That makes sense.
One problem I have been joined with is the idea is a nice one. But are you really responsible as joining group to get the in touch with the potential contributor itself? Or is your responsibility not more to watch that Fedora as a project, that all the teams making it easy to join? That would be more the job for you as taking care of each person who wants to contribute. That's, you know, the idea is a good, but it's not fought to the end.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this job, I right now say, is a big job, is a huge job. You would have, with that person that you have right now, not enough personnel to really watch all the teams if they make it easy. You have to think about low-hanging fruit, how can we create them? How can we make them very visible? That would be your job. Not to fetch each contributor personnel. That is the job for the teams. And you have to watch again,
so
the teams that there are mentors there, and that there are mentors who are really can be mentors. That's
the context for a lot of the story behind presentation. We're thinking about, like, when campus ambassadors do go out and they go to Hackfest or they go to a show at school, and they talk about Fedora, and Fedora is great, it's great meeting, and all these different things you can do, and some people get really fired up about it, and they go, okay, I want to contribute to Fedora, where do I get my kernel patch credits? You know, How do I commit to the kernel? I want to see a better widget in GNOME. And they've got no idea how all of these pieces fit together, where their contributions would fit. And the campus ambassadors can't scale when they're doing one-on-one in-person kind of stuff. Or maybe I just don't know enough about what these other groups that you're talking about do. That's definitely a part of it. But you can, if you meet people in person and you fly to Cambodia and you talk about Fedora Dance Design, and then you leave, and they need somewhere to go if they want to carry
they
on that
still
conversation.
Talk to me. I have a different understanding of mentoring. Means mentoring costs me really a lot of time, and I do it over a year or 2 years, or even if over 5 years is necessary.
Yes.
I'm still always responsible for the people I mentor. They still come with all the questions to me. I'm the first person they speak with. So I mean, I can tell you personally some experiences how people try to join Fedora and find their role in Fedora. If we talk about Cambodia, we can talk about Lisa Ban, and how she tried to get responsible for the Khmer translation, which was only with the help of Jared Smith to make her responsible inside TransFX for the translation, so that she can get users in the role of translator.
Mm-hmm.
It took us 1 year to get her in this role, and that is just encouraging. And that would be the job of, I think, of the joint, to watch to find such stories and find out where we fuck up and solve these problems.
I think that's a lot of what you're talking about, common stuff too.
Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of common onboarding tasks across all teams. And I think that that's what you're talking about, is that making sure that the onboarding process for each team is there, but it's also consistent too.
It's consistent, and it's not disencouraging to try to get to become a contributor.
One of the things that, after talking with the design team a little bit too, and I mentioned it yesterday during the mentors, was coming up with a series, figuring out if you wanted to be a member of a certain team, what does that process look like? Like right now, there's maybe a wiki page that talks about each of the steps on the tape, but there's no way to know where you are in the process right now, and that's what we talked about before. So coming up with a badge that says, you know, you're a member of...
The badge idea was the best idea. I think making for each step a badge, so we have to unify it for that. But we have, for a lot of things, already badges.
Yeah, so making it so that we're not creating a series of onboarding badges for every single group, because that would be overwhelming for the badges team, but taking the ones that are common, like...
Let's say this, for a lot of groups, we have already badges, so it's just that we have come up with some badges more for all the groups, but...
Well, including onboarding new people, which I see on the slide right there too. But having that process be